for us, whatever it is, whatever it is. Earlier, during the Kadamba Lama's period, Kadamba Lama's period, and there was a great Kadamba Lama who always worrying about Kadam teachings. Now these are, we're talking about 1100, 1200 in Tibet. 1100, 1200. So one of his disciples is also worrying about him, worrying about general teachings. What will happen to the Buddha's teaching? This degenerated age is developing. He's very worried. So one day, his teacher told him, Chi temba wogola magis, wogoga temba knus masowa kus. So he said, general Buddhism is not with us. Our own Buddhism should not go darkness within the individual. So his advice is whatever is happening in general society, you yourself and ourselves should see that we have a light. We should not go in the darkness, the voicelessness, and difficulties. That is exactly it is what we should do. Whatever the generally the country shift, policy, everything, whatever way, we should continue with the Buddha's idea of love, compassion oriented, and also individual improving day by day. We say we care, love and compassion, we care everybody. We also care ourselves. Remember, I used to say, if you do not take care of yourself, who else is going to take care of you? So remember that. So you have to take care of, concern everybody. Simultaneously, we have to take care of ourselves too. Ourselves too. So that's how we should keep our life together. Remember, our motivation of serving for every living being, recognizing every living being has been one time or the another mother of myself. And I'm here to repay their kindness. I'm here to serve people. It's very true. You can make that mind, and that mind doesn't bother you, but help you tremendously, which is very true. I try to do that, honestly. I'm not blowing my own horns, but I try to do that. I dedicate my life to the service of people, whatever I could, so I do. So that's what I do. So that doesn't bother me. It has given me a lot of peace and harmony and a lot of purpose for life. So that's what you people should do that. You actually, if you can't think of all living beings, think of your family, your spouse, your children, your parents, and you are living for them. You are there to serve them. It is the beginning. Theoretically, it is not Buddha, Buddha, body, mind. But it is the beginning. It is on the way. And that is how you should think every day. Happy to be alive today. When you wake up in the morning, whatever it is, 5 or 6 or whatever, you know, whatever, when you see the first electricity light or the light of, then be happy that you are alive. Appreciate kindness of the people. If you are a pure Buddhist, remember the kindness of Buddha Dharma and the Sangha kept you alive, will keep you alive. And if you are not, that's okay. But at least appreciate the life. Be happy about it. Now the second question. Today, I will dedicate my day to serve. If you want your family alone, that's fine. Extended, it's fine. All living being is great. So, but all living beings should not be the only name, but name and face. Problem with that is earlier the Buddhist logist of Buddhist practitioners, early, not necessarily Buddha logist. Earlier Buddhist practitioners have all sentient beings, and then this guy, what is his name, who translated Bodhisattva Chaya Avatara. Stephen Batchelor in Switzerland with the Geshe Rabdin studying the Dharma Treasury. So Stephen Batchelor one day told somebody, you are not all sentient beings, get out of my way. That happens really. It's very practical. It happens. And if it happens to you, you can do both, ignore them and do whatever you have to do, or you have to think. So the most important thing is, when you say all sentient beings, you should have little names and face and all that. So names and face, so that at least it is the people, it's not the dots, you know. Dotted lines, all, like even when you see the Obama's talking and then you see the television, all so many people, it all look like dot, especially when he was elected that night. Looked at the television, dotted lines. So you should not be, all sentient beings should not be dotted lines. Each of these dotted lines have a name, face, and living there, including Jesse Jackson crying there. It's there, you know. So honestly, so each, even you have a dotted lines, each one of these dotted lines have a people, including Jesse Jackson crying. So think about it, okay? And do whatever you have to do, you know. That doesn't mean you're doing your work, you have to change. But do whatever you have to do, dharma as well as material world, but motivation is to help them. That's where whatever you do, good work, it will become very, very important. We are also setting up this good motivation for this upcoming good year. Honestly, our good motivation for this upcoming good year. So all the benefit of all the beings, for the benefit of all beings, whatever I do, everything, including my daily chores, are meant for that. Meant for that. Cleaning of my room is a service of sentient beings. Cleaning of my home is a cleaning of my negativities. Remember this area, the Lamchungba, the small road area in the 16 Arahats, and the big road and his brother, small road. Remember, big brother was, the family had a curse. All the child doesn't survive. So soothsayers of those days have said, I have a way of doing it. So he put butter in the mouth of the kid, baby, and a little bit in the nose and face, and send it with the maid servant to a roadside. All great beings, whoever traveling, ask them to pray for the longevity of these little kids, this little kid. So the one good maid and active. So she went on the big road, so sitting there, and the great masters of different Hindu traditions came one by one, and each one of them prayed, this guy will live long, become, join my order, become the most learned person. So then goes away. Including Buddha at the end came. This guy will live long and join my order and the most learned. So the soothsayer told, when the sunset comes, if the kid is still alive, bring back to the home. If the kid is dead, then take it to the funeral home. So by the time Buddha left, the kid is alive, so they brought back to home and are happy, very happy, because they have been able to survive the kid. And this kid went in each and every one of those Hindu schools and become mastered, and not satisfied, join the other one. Finally joined Buddha's order and become Arahat called Big Road, Arahat Big Road. Big Path, Baba Bhuli. Then the younger brother came, soothsayer did the same thing. This time the maid happened to be very lazy one, so went next street. There are not so many people goes. So she waited a whole day, nobody came, except Buddha came at the end of the day and prayed the same thing, found the kid alive, brought back, and then this kid went to each and every school as the brother went, and instead of becoming a master, they all beat him up and throw him out. So finally, he went to his own brother. So his own brother thought about it. So he found if he's been wrathful, that will help him. If he's been brotherly loving won't help much. So when he's teaching something, not learning, so he also kick him out of the ashram. So while he is crying on the those brick built little walls. So Buddha came by and said, why are you crying? So he said, I'm the most stupid and no one is helping me and this and that. He said, well, would you like to follow me? And he said, no, I don't. But I went to your ashram and my own brother threw me out. So he said, your own brother is Arahat. I am a Buddha. I have a different way of doing it. So he said, if you promise not throw me out, then I will come. So Buddha said, okay, I will not throw you out. So he came. So the Buddha taught him first, sweeping the floor of a temple. And he let him sweep. He'd been sweeping it. Then, one day, Buddha told him, while you're sweeping, can you say, dubang? Du means dust, clear dust. So he couldn't remember that. When he remembered dust, he forgot clear. When he remembered clear, he forgot the dust. So that he keep on struggle for months. And the Buddha instructed monks, when they see him sweeping, remind him, dubang, dubang, that's clear dust, clear dust, clear dust. Keep on saying nearby. Maybe he'd learn that one day. Then the another day, Buddha said, timabang, clear ignorance. They did the same thing. He had struggled for a long time. So one day, he not only learned clear the dust and clear the dirt, Not he only he learned, he said, the dust is not the ordinary dust, the dust of attachment. Dust is not an ordinary dust, dust of anger. Dust is not an ordinary dust, dust of jealousy. So does the dirt is not an ordinary dirt. It is internal dirt of ignorance. So then, just by doing that alone, he picked it up, everything. On those days, it's a symbol. And these days, for us, too many things to do. Those days, it's quite a symbol. I think it is just because of the Buddha's thing, and honestly. So that's what it is. That's what. So great. So today, and this is our example. So if when you're cleaning your house, room, or whatever, vacuuming, I mean, you are not sucking the ordinary dust, but sucking the hatred, anger, and the jealousy, and the ignorance of our mind. Pure mind will appear then. So even cleaning alone can reach quite a lot. So many of you may think I may not be able to do too much, but be able to clean your room, that will be good enough alone with what we talk, think about it. Okay, think about it, that will support your cleaning house. So that is important. And each and every activities that shared by Buddha through the Tibetan Buddhism is capable of delivering individual to a certain extent of development. Honestly, each and every. Even you simply learn to say, O mani padme hum, and that is alone good enough. Many old Tibetans, olden times, many of them just simply said, O mani padme hum, and they said 100,000 million times, a number of millions in life, they say, but that's all they know. That's all they know. And that is good enough to make the life worthwhile. That is our purpose. So, I like to say that much and welcome into the new, great, wonderful year that we're looking for. And each one of those, you know, work you do should serve your purpose. And that's what you have to choose.